to the group clearing, and today we're dealing with being witnessed, which is kind of an emotional intimacy that allows us to really just be seen. Okay, so let me just share a little bit about some of the interferences with that, some of the reasons that we're not experiencing that kind of emotional intimacy. But wait, let me just share a little bit first about being witnessed, okay? Being witnessed is one of the universal laws. There are universal laws that are actual, it's not that they're written laws, but they're energetic, high-level, divine consciousness, spiritual laws, okay? And those laws are for our evolution, you know what I mean? It's like it helps us to find the journey back to the self. So the aspect around being witnessed, that component is vital. You know, it's like when in our world we can experience, connecting with people, and to be witnessed means to be witnessed at the deepest aspects of ourselves. Okay? So have you ever just taken some time and just looked at yourself in your eyes in the mirror? Have you ever done that? How long were you able to do that for without the body getting uncomfortable?
Not very long.
Not very long. Not even a minute for most people. Okay? So if you can look in a mirror for just less than a minute and get uncomfortable and want to turn away, what makes you think you're going to be looking in somebody else's eyes for more than a minute and not get uncomfortable and want to turn away? Okay? If you can't do that with another human being, what makes you think you're having intimacy? You know, here's one thing. People jump into bed with people really fast nowadays, you know? I mean, I remember when I was younger too, not like really young, but as it got more, you know, like maybe let's say 10, 15 years ago, everybody's going to bed with people, having sex with people, thinking they're being intimate, but there's no intimacy. You're just having sex. And the piece around leaning out of your body, you are not in touch with what you are experiencing inside, okay? So you get two people, they meet, oh, we're gonna have sex together because there's an attraction, okay? But while they move in that direction, they're both leaning out. So nobody's fully inside of themselves. No one's fully sharing themselves. If you were, you'd be feeling all your discomfort and your fears and anxiety around being seen. When you think about yourself and you think about your life and you think about who you are, do you ever get nervous or afraid just kind of like looking in? Okay. That's because there are aspects and hidden things happening inside of you that you don't know are there. Okay, so partly what's happening is you've got lifetimes of experiences that get imprinted in the soul imprint and you carry it forward, and you've done many things, okay? It's like if you look at all the people in the world, everything you have a judgment on, if you have any kind of charge in your body, you've done it sometime, somewhere, someplace, somehow, with somebody. I don't care if it's this lifetime or another lifetime. You have done it, okay? So if we have all these experiences that we judge to be wrong, we have a judgment on them because we've learned through society that having certain thoughts, having certain feelings, having certain desires, wants, needs, hopes, dreams, desires are not okay, that you're selfish, you're a bad person, you're born in sin. All these things contribute to you gotta hide who you are. And then when you have all these things buried inside, you don't know what's there. So when you look in someone's eyes and you just hold this, everything inside is gonna start to stir. Everything that's unconscious is gonna stir. The entities, the implants, the dark forces, the unconscious emotions that are yours is going to stir. So intimacy becomes something that becomes really frightening. People will don't do anything other than go into intimacy, you know? Because it's like intimacy means being seen. So with our topic being witnessed, That means that we want to start moving in a direction where we are sharing who we are and being witnessed in our own selves, in the expression of ourself, whatever that is. Unfortunately, you can't know your true self because there's so much garbage in the way. Have you ever noticed that after a clearing, sometimes you kind of have this feeling like, whoa, who am I?
Okay. Then you create another new story.
Okay. That's because you've been living all these things that are not you, these beliefs that are not you. You have not been your divine true self, and you have felt and believed that what you're experiencing is you. And as things get lifted out and they're not there anymore, that's why you have that feeling like, whoa, who am I? Who am I? Whoa, okay, this is a little uncomfortable. And yet, all we're really doing is coming more and more and more back to the true authentic self that we really are. So being witness is a journey of intimacy. Intimacy. So how many people have been married a long time or have been in a relationship more than a couple of years? Okay? Uh-huh. Cool. Are there still places where you don't share or didn't share your feelings, your deepest feelings, your deepest desires, your thoughts, your hopes, all of that? Everyone, I'm getting it, like, yeah, okay? So if you can't be witnessed in who you are, you're never going to have connection, full connection to self, unless you keep coming to clearings and we get everything out. Then your divine self is there, and then it doesn't matter, because you'll just be yourself, it doesn't matter. You won't have any thoughts that stop you or inhibit you or block you. You'll just be who you are. Okay? So being witnessed, like I said, is universal law. It's an absolute. We can all go hide in our room, or we can have a best friend that we'll share some things with, but there's always some kind of withhold somewhere. I don't care who you know, I don't care how long you've had intimacy, somewhere you've always had a withhold. Because you're judging, fearing, worrying that someone's going to judge you, make you wrong, and any kind of judgment means being ostracized. Okay, so somewhere in our past we've got that kind of thing where you did something and then you got banned and then you know, on your own and you died. That's still anchored in. Have you noticed how intense the feeling gets at the thought of being judged? It's intense, isn't it? It gets wacko intense in the body, okay? These are all indicators of entities in the body, dark force stuff, past life energies, past life experiences, beliefs, all these different things that cause us to feel like we're not okay who we are. So the being witnessed means risking everything. It means if you really share who you are, your mind thoughts are going to be things like, well, maybe they won't like me anymore, maybe they won't love me anymore, maybe they're going to leave me, maybe they're going to judge me, maybe they're going to hate me. You know, all these things, none of them are real, and yet the mind just kind of goes off into the mind train and creates all these illusions about what's going to happen. That's the self-preservation, that's the protection. So in the clearing work, so in being witnessed, just the thought of being witnessed at some of these deeper places, like I said earlier, is going to cause this anxiety in the body. So once we get going, that's what we're going to start lighting up. Because the clearer that energy is, the less fear there is to just be who you are, then you'll take more risks and you will expose more and you'll share more. And pretty soon you'll start to discover that, well, yeah, sometimes you are being judged. But here's the thing. You're being judged every day by somebody. Even your own self, right? So you're judging yourself, but somewhere, someone's always finding something right or wrong with you. You can't stop it. It's not going to ever change. That's what human beings do. We're comparing. We're finding fault because it makes us feel like we're better. So in the clearing work with this kind of the witnessing aspect, we're going to do several different layers of it. So at the first thought of, like, so those of you who have had intimate, close relationships, okay, even if they're over, I'm going to have you just let yourself remember what that was like. Okay, remember the sensation. Remember that. In those of you who are currently, just remember, okay? So what you're going to do is you're going to just think about that person, and you're going to let yourself just remember intimacy, being close, sharing, and then you're going to take it to the point to where you start to feel that anxiety, that fear, that like that angst in the body. Usually you're going to feel it kind of like in the core, it'll kind of be in the belly area, a little bit in the solar plexus. So this is all the energy that's in the body moving around. And once you let yourself just be with that memory, that feeling, once you've lit that feeling up, basically, you're just going to relax into that feeling and let yourself get a sense of the emotion. The emotion, okay? There's a difference between emotion and thoughts or ideas or, you know, concepts. Feeling and emotion, we feel it. Okay, so if in fact the first thing that you do feel is perhaps like an anxiety, because that's one of the things that's going to get really stirred up in intimacy and someone just really gazing and looking into one another's eyes, or even hugging. I've got some exercises on, we've got exercises on our website or something where we've got these intimacy practices to play with. And if you work with it and play with it, things are going to happen. Stuff's going to come up. You're going to become aware of more of your own discomfort inside. And that's the intention. It's like awareness is the first step to anything. You have awareness and, oh, now you have choice. Without awareness, you don't have choice because you have no idea of the choices. So with awareness, you'll become aware. Like, for example, if you're standing, one of the exercises is, well, actually, it's two things, several things. One of them is looking in each other's eyes, okay? But it's really about, as you're doing that, you're telling the truth, okay? So if you're feeling anxious, you go, oh, I can feel where I feel a lot of anxiety in my belly. Doesn't feel real good. And then if you stay with it, you might actually start to feel really scared. If you really stay with it, you might feel terrified, okay? Then underneath all of that, there might be like extreme grief or despair. So the more you can feel into what's happening, then the more opportunity for releasing it and letting it leave the body. The thing about emotions is it's energy. Emotions, energy in motion. Okay, keep that in mind. Every time there's an emotion that you have, if you stop it, guess where it goes? You push it down into the body. And every time that happens, you collect more and more emotions that are hidden, and those also amplify the experience when you are being witnessed. Because now you've got all these feelings that you've been pushing down your entire life, because somehow you're judging them as wrong, otherwise you let them freely flow. How about little kids when they're children and they're crying because they get upset because someone took their toy, or they get upset because they wanted to touch something and they weren't allowed, okay? So they're immediately learning that their feelings, their needs, their wants are not acceptable. There must be something wrong with them as the conclusion that gets drawn. So stuff gets pushed down. These are all components that contribute to the inability to truly just be the authentic self and be witnessed in who you are, whatever that is. You know, whether it's what you eat or where you like to go, or if you like to do movies, or even in your intimate sexual connections, it's like it all presents. You don't even have to be in an intimate relationship to have this feeling, these feelings come up for you. All it takes is thinking someone can see who you are. This is why standing in front of a group gets really uncomfortable. Okay? So when you stand up in front of a group and your belly starts to get whacked, you start to get nervous, you start to get flushed, you lose your thoughts, what's really happening is all the things inside, all the buried places, all the past lives, all the entities, all the implants, all the interferences, all the thoughts, the beliefs, all of this is getting activated because now you're standing and everybody's looking at you. So the body gets terrified. Okay? I promise you, the clearer your energy is, standing in front of people will be no big deal. because there's nothing more to hide. There's nothing you don't know. Okay? So it's an unraveling. It isn't like instant pudding where we just shake it up and here we are done. It's like, no, it's an unraveling. It's a journey. Okay? So these are tools also, like being witness is a tool. If you got a good friend, people you trust, you can do this together with them. You can make that connection. You can talk to the, you know, you can, hey, you guys, let's be witnessed. Okay? So even those little three exercises that we have, the one, the eye gazing, the hugging, and what was the other one? I can't remember. Do you remember? There was three, I think. We had three. Yeah, doesn't matter. But each of those are things you can do with someone you trust. Because if you just stand and look at someone in the eyes, or just, you know, just do that for 5, 10, 15 minutes, I promise you stuff's going to come. And if you have someone that you can work with, and as it comes up, then you can start clearing it. I'm talking deep stuff, okay? It's like our life is always triggered. We're always having reactions to something. And when we work with it with intention, then we have the opportunity to clear, move stuff out of the way. So the witnessing aspect, like I was saying earlier, you know, it's easy to just hide who we are. We can isolate, we can be alone, or we can be around people and still feel lonely, but there's that isolation that happens when there's all these energies inside that are mostly are not us, and mostly not from this lifetime. So we're the culmination, like if you could see the soul imprint, you would see all the wounding, all the traumas, all the horrors that you have lived, all the things that you have done that you might in your mind judge as wrong or bad, okay? In the bigger picture, there really is no wrong or right or good or bad. It just doesn't exist. It's all about experience. And there's agreements, okay? So the witnessing today, we're going to start unraveling and start cleaning up some of the energies that are making it uncomfortable to be witnessed. You know, that's partly what the clearing is about, is get this, start moving the energies. So being witnessed, there's a couple stages of it. So there's that really deep one where you really just feel, sometimes you actually feel like you're punched in the belly because it's like so terrifying, okay? So sometimes when you feel that, it's difficult to go underneath that. So I just want to just play with that a little bit before we actually get started. Were people experiencing that? Like when you think about like closeness, intimacy, like when you think about someone that you've been involved with, a partner, okay? And you think about them and you think about places where you haven't told them everything or you haven't shared different things. Or, I mean, remember back like when women stayed home more and men were working and the woman would go out and she'd get a dent on the car and she'd be terrified to come tell her husband, okay? That intense fear, even though she had never had any kind of experience with him where he got that irate, but still there was that needing to hide. Or how about as a kid or a teenager, you're out doing stuff and you think you've done something and the last thing you want is for your parents to know? Okay? Or, you know, like, or even hiding it. I can feel you. You guys are getting whacked right now. Stuff's lighting up. I can feel it. Okay, so the intense stuff is like, it's hard to navigate. So let's do that. We're going to navigate the intensity so that you can go underneath it, okay? Because what happens for most people is they'll hit that intensity and then they can't navigate it. All they're doing is feeling nauseated, they're feeling the anxiety, they're feeling sick, they're feeling afraid. And if you've been taking any classes or knowing about healing work, you know, the key is to surrender. But this is like an energy that you can surrender to it, but you're not going to find what's underneath it because you're going to be stuck in a frequency that's too static. Okay? So if we can go underneath that static while it's happening, this is going to help you to start feeling and accessing and lighting up some of the deeper stuff. Okay? Mm-hmm.